It's 12 o'clock on a Monday. I'm Blaze.
I'm Juliana. This is Zhao Yu.
What up?
And welcome to
Rave Train.
In news this week, Electric Forest is now going to be 2 weeks long.
2 weeks?
Yeah, they extended it to 2 weeks. That's pretty interesting because it seems like a lot of festivals are kind of scaling back, but Electric Forest is actually growing.
That's good to hear, though. I really want to go to Electric Forest. It looks so beautiful. Yeah. But what if my friends aren't going the same weekend I am?
Yeah, well, I think a big part of it is that Electric Forest tends to gear more towards the conscious community and transformational festivals, but it also meets EDM, which is really interesting, and it's growing.
Exploding.
Like that's what I think these promotion companies and festivals need to start gearing themselves towards is a more conscious community.
I like that. We need to be more conscious. I like these conscious communities.
So what's going on in the show this week?
This week we have Shufflers Worldwide. They're going to be doing some really crazy dancing for us. And on the decks we have Jack Spaidz.
Awesome. And now it's time for Zhao Yu's Pearl of Wisdom.
Raver who stand on toilet, high on pot.
Zhao Yu, press play.
On this week's episode, we have
Jack Spaidz.
What up, Jack? How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, thank you. So what are you going to be playing for us this week?
Tonight, I'm going to be doing techno, psytrance, and hard trance in 15 minutes.
Holy crap.
Boom.
That's a lot to hit in 15 minutes.
Absolutely.
I'm excited.
Take I can't wait. All right, let's do it.
Oh,
Thank you.
And that's our show for the week.
Tune in next time.
We'll catch you at the after party.
What's up, guys? It's Johnny Blaze, and this is my rant. This is the part of the show where we talk about controversial issues in the rave community. So let's get right into it. This week, we are talking about food at raves, specifically health food at raves. What the freak is the deal, people? Do you guys enjoy eating greasy, processed pepperoni pizza and bacon wrapped hot dogs? I mean, yeah, sure. I mean, we all do love that stuff. It tastes delicious. But we are at festivals for 10, 12 hour long days. It's freaking blazing hot out. I mean, wouldn't it be better to eat like a delicious salad? Maybe people are looking at me right now through their YouTube or internet and saying this guy's crazy. But for real, we can get some really good, fresh, organic superfoods, some juicy smoothies, some juiced up micro, macro, ultra food that can just juice it, make your system feel amazing so you can rock out the party with no problems. Honestly, I think some of the issues with going to festivals and feeling sick, honestly, is because of the food. It's just processed, disgusting garbage. It's chemicals. You guys realize that you're poisoning your system by eating freaking something made in a factory by a corporation in order to save money. And why can't we invest back into the vendors that are serving food and get people who want to be part of our community, be part of the festival scene, and get really good stuff? I mean, I think some of these more transformational music festivals, like Lightning in a Bottle, they're all vegan. They have such good food there, and people feel so healthy the entire time. Yet you'll go to something like EDC, and your only option is, you know, food trucks and freaking, like I said, you know, like churros and that lemonade that they sell for $12, $14. It's just high fructose corn syrup and water. You know, why can't we get some quality stuff here? But hit me up. What's your thought on foods? If we super juiced and super fooded the Bay Festival community, I think we'd all be way better off. That's my thought. Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, find me. We're talking about food at festivals. What's your opinion, people? Hit me up.